I was recently asked to do a video about removing the main shaft out of a Singer 66. I don't really recommend doing that unless you absolutely have to. And I happen to have one completely out of a machine here. And I'll show you why I don't really recommend doing this. First of all, in order to remove the main shaft, you have to loosen the set screw that holds the cam on. That's the cam that drives the fork for the stitch length regulator. So obviously the stitch length regulator rod has to come out. That cam has to be loosened. There is a set screw on it here. All right, so that's got to get loosened up. There's a pivot point on the top of the machine and a bolt on the bottom of the machine. It's going to start rolling away. That form the pivot points for the vertical shaft. You have to remove the block on the front of the shaft where the needle bar connections and the connections for the thread take-up arm are all made. That's got to come off. There's a set screw on the side of the machine that you have to loosen that keeps positioned the front bearing. Now, once you've got all that done as prep, of course, with the balance wheel off, then you have to insert through that hole in the back with the cover plate off. You have to insert a 1/4-inch brass rod or whatever you've got. I don't have a brass rod. I took an old electrician's spade bit that was pretty dead. I ground off the point. I put a little bit of an arc to it so I could slip it in through there and then give this the old tappy tap tap with the hammer. I have to move it around a couple different positions here to drive this bearing out the front. You get that bearing driven out the front, and then you still have to screw around with very carefully sliding the shaft around, keeping in mind that you've got this vertical shaft here, which is a casting, so you can get this cam off and work this shaft out the front of the machine. Not easy. And it's very, very easy to damage or break the casting that forms this vertical shaft. Ask me how I know. Yep, I've busted one of these. So that's why I don't recommend doing that. It's usually not required. I have never seen a front bearing that was seized up to prevent that couldn't be just cleaned out with oil and just exercise. Likewise, the rear bearing for the main shaft is actually just drilled into the casting. So yeah, you never see these things really seized up that badly that you can't just exercise it free with oils or other lubricants to cut through any crud. Very rarely do you have to take the vertical shaft out, which requires removing the main shaft. These cams, they're not going to wear out. You know, the stitch length regulator moves on those, and everything. These parts just generally don't get that kind of wear. Is my point. Actually, that's backwards. That would be oriented that way. Anyway, that's why I don't recommend taking them out. I happen to have this one out of a machine for a completely different reason, but at least I had it available, and I could show you how the parts are oriented amongst themselves here. Now, if you want to see how this here, I'm going to use my dental implement as a pointer here, and you can see how as the bend forms the cam, the cage forms the cam follower, and you can see how this pitman arm will go back and forth. And that's what causes the oscillation, or drives, I should say, the oscillation of the hook in the 66. The 99 is set up the same way, as is the 192, and a boatload of other models. But yeah, if you don't have to take the main shaft out, if it's not absolutely necessary, please don't do it. If you're going to be painting the machine, you can mask this stuff. You don't have to take that out. All right, thanks for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.